Okay, so this is day 8 of the worksheet. So first it says describe the difference between sine, inverse of sine times sine pi over 3. So first we'll do that one. So sine negative 1 times sine pi over 3. That's basically, so sine to the power of negative 1 is the inverse, so it's basically arcsine. And so sine pi over 3 is, so pi over 3 is basically like 0.866. So when we do put this into, one way is to do it is like from the calculator and we get pi over 3 for that. Or we can also look at the graph of the arc sine and see that when we do have 0.866, the coordinate is pi over 3. So we know that the inverse, since this is arc sine, the inverse sine negative 1, and then pi over 3 is, it cancels out and we get pi over 3. The next one is sine times sine, the inverse of sine pi over 3. This would be undefined because if we look at the sine, the arc sine's graph, we can see that if we do go pi over 3, there wouldn't, it would be off of the restricted area, so that means it would be undefined because there is no y. It's a restricted domain, so there would be no output for pi over 3, and so that's how we know it. That's right. So yeah, sine negative 1 sine pi 3 is pi over 3, and sine negative 1 pi over 3 is undefined. So when do inverse trigs undo the trig functions, and when do they not? They do undo when the input for the equation, when there is an output and the x has, it has an output for the trig and the inverse. So, for example, we saw that for this one, where there was a output for this pi over 3, there was one here and one here. So we know that this would undo each other. That's why this sine negative 1 and sine canceled out or undid each other, and we got pi over 3. The next is, when do they not? So they inverses do not undo each other when it is undefined, which means that the x has no value. The x value is not on that inverse graph, which would just make it undefined, and it would be a negative value. So we saw that in the sine negative 1 pi over 3, because for this pi over 3, for the arc sine, it would be over the restricted 1 domain, so that means it would be undefined, there would be no output value, so that means that's when it does not undo the trig function. So discuss the graphs of inverse trig, sine, cosine, tangent, and why they're restricted. So first we have the sine equation, the domain is this. We have the arc sine, which is the inverse of sine. We have, this is the graph, this is the restricted domains. This is our cosine. This is the domain range. We have the inverse of cosine, which is arcsine. And we have, this is our domain, the restricted domains. Okay, and then we have tan. This is the graph. This is our domain and range. This is our inverse tan, which is arctan. And this is our restricted range. So we have a restricted domain, because there are, because then if there wasn't a restricted domain, it would have a, it wouldn't be a function anymore because there would be many inputs, even though it's the same output, so the x value repeated, and so that means it would not pass the vertical line test, and also, that's why it has to be restricted, because since this is a inverse, it would be a 180, like a reflection, but if we do that, there would just be more more input, so that would mean we can't have that, so that's why the domain would be -1, 1 for this arc sine and -1, 1 for the domain for the arc cosine. And it has to be invertible. So that's why we have the need of a restricted domain. And yeah, that was day 8.